Welcome back. This is your friendly neighborhood monkey sentinel, and I was going to do an entirely different video on an entirely different topic that I have been working on. Before we get into that, though, I would like to take you down memory lane with Monkey Sentinel. You may remember that I mentioned my grandmother got swindled by a televangelist. This guy's name was Robert Tilton. Here's a little clip.
This gives the devil a buckeye. This is taking the very thing that Satan has used on you, the lack of money, and it's taken that very sword that he's used on you.
So she got taken in by this guy, and she sent this guy her life savings, and she died destitute in one of the most depressing, sad nursing homes, if you want to call it that, I have ever seen. You can see why scams that prey on people wanting to protect other people, wanting to protect children, they're other people too, they're just small, and wanting to protect animals, this kind of thing affects me. So that's my story for you.
Okay, so the structure of this is going to be a little different than what I usually do. I've had to go back and re-record several sections because of the behavior of the entity that I am discussing in this video. Suffice it to say that I am not amused. This organization isn't worth the effort. They have about 26 followers on Facebook. They have minimal views on YouTube. They have almost zero presence on social media whatsoever. They themselves are not worth it. Tracking down how a scam operates and sharing that with the general public, that is in fact worth it.
Now I know what you're thinking. You're thinking, okay, Monkey Sentinel, if that really is your name, what does this have to do with monkeys? And what the bleep are you talking about? Well, let me tell you. It all started when I got this email. I get this email from someone who says that they are the CEO of an organization called Born Free SA, and then gives me a reference number. I was intrigued by this because Born Free is an internationally renowned group of sanctuaries and animal activist groups. So there's Born Free UK and Born Free USA, and they do tremendous work.
So they're calling themselves Born Free SA, which is an awful lot like Born Free USA. It's almost as though the difference is a single letter. And those of us who follow this send out emails to the legitimate Born Free Foundation and let them know what is happening. This all takes place over the course of about 10 to 12 days. Naturally, the Born Free Foundation gets back to us and says, no, we are not at all affiliated with this organization. We have no idea who these people are. On the same day we get these emails, Born Free SA, which I'm just now going to call BFSA, issues this lengthy statement about how they have never attempted to confuse their image with that of the Born Free Foundation, and that they are their own distinct entity, yada, 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 yada. I find that to be disingenuous at best, because their website and their Facebook still to this day does not have a disclaimer. It does not have any kind of clarity statement. You have to dig to find even the old post that says, no, we're not affiliated with the Born Free Foundation.
So they go on to talk about their dedication to the protection and conservation of wildlife, particularly in the realm of non-human primates. We're deeply committed to raising awareness about the exploitation of monkeys on social media platforms. All things that I would say, yes, 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 right? It's practically taken from my own words. In pursuit of this mission, we are keen to share your insightful videos and exposés on our YouTube channel. This channel is not monetized. Furthermore, we do not accept donations for our work. Your work serves as a powerful tool in shedding light on the plight of these animals, and we believe that by amplifying your message, we can collectively work towards effecting positive change. Now, on the surface, that sounds like a lot of good words put together. So on the very day that I get this email, I am also starting to pick up a lot of chatter on the back channels of the monkey world. It makes it sound like I'm part of like some secret organization and, you know, we've got like a secret monkey handshake. And that's all true. We do. Not. It's just, you get to know people and you know the good ones from the not good ones and people talk. And so there was a lot of chatter about this NGO out of South Africa. Where did they come from? They have a YouTube page and a Facebook page and they've got a website and they've got annual reports. They have all of this stuff, but they literally just launched.
So when I get this email, the first thing that I do, well, one of the first things that I do is go and look at the About section on their YouTube channel. The About section has changed quite a bit over time. The first version of the About section was basically a ripoff of my own bio. Like, you're going to send a request to use my videos and yet you're copying my bio. Maybe they thought that I would be flattered. Because you know what they say, imitation is the sincerest form of flattery, that mediocrity can pay to greatness. That's the rest of the quote, just so you know. It's a good quote. I asked them to change it, and to their credit, they do a bit, although the structure is still the same, and they're still using some of my language. I'm not attached to the bio. There's nothing impressive in it at all. It's just that they took it and claimed it as their own, and then turned around and made social media posts against other organizations accusing them of fraud and plagiarism. And y'all, the irony there is so rich, I need a glass of milk to dunk it in.
So this reference number, they're awfully proud of it. They use it a lot. It's on their website, it's on their YouTube, it's on their Facebook, it's on almost all of their correspondence and social media posts. And they use it to establish a sense of legitimacy. As in, hey, we are a registered nonprofit with South Africa, and you can look it up. And it's true, you can. And it's true, they are. They are registered as of March 12th, 2024, as a voluntary association. That's interesting for a couple of reasons. The first is the date. They have implied on their social media and on their website, sometimes just explicitly stated, that they have been active for months, if not years. Perhaps they have been active in another capacity, but they certainly have not been active in any official capacity as BFSA, at least, not as a registered NPO. The other thing that is interesting is that in South Africa, the nonprofits are tiered. Voluntary association is at the bottom. So it has the least amount of regulation and oversight and accountability standards. So yeah, the reference number checks out. That doesn't speak to the character of the organization.
So we're going to take a look at their website now. It's going to be something of a hot mess because their website has changed a lot since it debuted on March 12th, 2024. Anytime someone makes a negative comment or points out a discrepancy in their information or practices or dates, then they go back and they try to fix it to make it seem as though that issue never existed. It's very problematic. But luckily, things like screen capture and archive sites exist. One of the first things that I notice when I hit this website is the AI-generated imagery going in the slideshow on the banner. I teach about visual culture. I literally teach a class about AI. And it's, you know, it's complicated. I have complex feelings about it. Using it here strikes me as extremely strange. If you are a legitimate organization that has had years of experience, as you claim, working with the conservation of these animals, why not use your own photos so that people can see that good work? It establishes a sense of legitimacy. And these images are so strangely inappropriate for a conservation center or a sanctuary or animal rights group or whatever it is that they're defining themselves as. You have baby macaques with clothing on, and that is deeply problematic when you consider the fact that pet channels are one of the biggest problems that we face with social media exploitation of these animals. You've got this weird looking dude who is just kind of hanging out with the orangutans here. It's all peculiar and strange and surreal and unsettling. Not the kind of vibe you want for a legitimate organization. Even the logo strikes me as strange. When I first saw it, I was convinced that I had seen it somewhere before. So I did a reverse image search. I probably spent 2 days doing a reverse image search on this damn logo. And it's really just an amalgamation of so many monkey logos out there. And it strikes me as something that AI would generate, actually, because that's precisely what AI does. And there are these little inconsistencies in the logo itself that makes me think that. So like this strange little, this part isn't quite smooth. And then there's this weird switch to a different brown here. And then there is this unexplained little crescent moon thing going here. It's all just weird, right? So the vibe is off. So the big thing I notice after that, of course, is this big donate button down over on the left-hand side of the screen. What's significant about it is how it has developed over the last 3 weeks or so. When you first clicked on it, it would take you to a page with their causes. I'm using scare quotes for that, where you could basically pick one of two and then go to a PayPal account and then make a donation. Like they were taking donations. It has changed now to we are no longer accepting donations. And I don't know why that is. I don't know if it's because people have pointed out that perhaps that's problematic, or if they have reached their goal of $150,000. I'm not quite sure. One of these causes is empowering justice for monkeys. I don't know what that is. And it's using an image that looks like it was curated by Wes Anderson. Wes Anderson in a like a fever dream. And then the other image is this fight against monkey exploitation in Asian countries, which I find interesting because, you know, in South Africa, they have a lot of problems with old world primates like vervets. I mean, like they need help too, you know? So this image has the baby macaque in the clothing, like I pointed out. About the vervets, if you scroll down, you can see that there is completed causes, and one of them is the vervet sanctuary. This is not to be confused with the Vervet Forest Foundation, and there is no information about a legitimate vervet sanctuary outside of the Vervet Forest Foundation. Nothing. There's not even a link. You can't click on it and get any more information about this. These other two buttons here, they just take you to the same page. There is no volunteer program. And the take part is, I think it's just there to take up space on this webpage, to be honest. It doesn't mean anything. It's the same exact thing. All right. So we're going to keep going down because it just keeps going. There's still more. And this is just the homepage. We won't go through every single page. Don't worry. I'm not going to do that to you. But this first page is a doozy. So we get to this section with the three images. And when I got here, I just laughed the first time because I have seen all of these images before. They're stock images. And of course, we do some backup checks. And yes, they have appeared in all kinds of things. But then I thought, you know what? I'm just going to put all three of these names into a Google search altogether and just see what happens. And it's pretty great. It looks like Amelia and Gracie and Albert are their patients with No Pain USA. And they are also patients of the St. George Charity Fund or participants in it. They are all paragraphs at this point. I am a paragraph. They're also members of the Christ Academy, which this page was about fishing. It's very strange. They get around. They have a lot of energy, these folk. Yeah, I mean, come on. So there's that. So the current version of the website has no images at all because other people have pointed out the discrepancies of these three stock people. And I find that pretty funny. There's no last names to these people either. But their first names are still the same. And we can choose our own images now. I love that. I love the community activism there. It gives me the warm fuzzies. So we're going to keep going. And now we're here at these little membership buttons. These are little things that you put at the bottom of your website whenever you are a member, like you're an affiliate with a particular organization. In this case, these buttons belong to the Global Federation of Animal Sanctuaries and the Pan-Africa Sanctuary Alliance. Both of these are organizations that accredit sanctuaries. They're voluntary, but a lot of sanctuaries participate in them because it gives them a kind of some oversight and it gives them some legitimacy. So if you go to Global Federation of Animal Sanctuaries and you look up, for example, the Vervet Monkey Foundation, well, you're going to find it. You will also find Born Free USA, but you will not find Born Free South Africa, because Born Free South Africa is not a member of this group. Yet their inclusion of the button implies that they are. Now, they have made a Facebook post or social media post that claims that they make no such claim, and that's all well and good, but the presence of these buttons is a deceptive thing. It does, in fact, imply membership. That's why people put them there on their websites. It's the same thing with Pan-Africa Sanctuary Alliance. It's not affiliated with them whatsoever. But the last thing that I want to talk about is all the way down at the bottom. This little guy here, the copyright. When this first went up, the copyright was listed as 2023. I've got a screenshot of that. Now, this is interesting given that the website has only been in existence since March 12, 2024. And they could have gotten their copyright for it before then. But within a few days, they had switched the copyright to 2021. Again, it's these little retroactive changes that bother me. I find that disturbing. Now we're going to skip over to the About section. This was updated recently because someone pointed out that the copyright issue was questionable. So they've updated it with this. And again, this is this kind of retroactive change to make it look like it's always been this way. Here's the reason why. Born Free SA was conceived as a concept in 2021, with a vision to champion the cause of wildlife conservation and protection. Do you see? All of that is completely, it's not something that you can check, right? It's all unverifiable things. It's a concept and it's a vision. All of the information, all of the words, they sound noble, but they're like icing on a cake. There's no substance beneath them. So once you start to dig, like, okay, give me your specific examples, there's nothing there. It all falls apart. Whenever you dig into a grift, all you get is smoke and mirrors. There's a merchandise tab where you can click and then not get merchandise because there's nothing there. There are books that they're self-published. And when you self-publish through Amazon and Kindle, you are required to tell them that it's generated in AI, but you're not required to tell the public.
So this gentleman here, he's a very interesting guy. Everything that I am telling you comes straight from his social media profiles or from his posts or from a very cursory internet search. He's a busy guy, this Ian. Busy, busy, busy. Has his hand in a lot of things.
This guy looks a lot like this guy. And this guy was at Angkor Wat just last year on a tour offered by one of the main VOs. He was there handling the monkeys. So I think that that's interesting. What a coinkydink, if I may quote Bugs Bunny, the illustrious Bugs Bunny. Thank you, Bugs, for your service. One of my favorite novels of all time is Neil Gaiman's American Gods. And in it, Odin is depicted as a grifter, but he's a really good one. He's a god, so what do you expect? I just think Odin would be really embarrassed by all of this. That's what I think. In the end, even though it's really funny, It's also really, really disturbing because there are some people that are going to stumble across this organization and they're going to look at that website and they're not going to look twice and they're going to think, oh, wow, they're doing really good things for monkeys, and then they're going to send them money. And those are people like my grandma. That makes me really mad. Like, it really pisses me off.
Mr. McGee, don't make me angry. You wouldn't like me when I'm angry.
Yeah, listen, I appreciate you hanging around and listening to this. I hope it was insightful for you. I hope you got some useful information out of it on like how to spot scams and that sort of thing. Again, I don't make any money doing this. I don't want any money doing this. I don't ask for donations. I do this because I feel like it's the right thing to do. I'll see you next time. Say goodnight, Gracie.
This will give the devil a bugger!